Everybody knows what cancer is, and that a tumor is a growing lump of cells. But have you ever heard of a tumor growing hair and teeth before? This is a special type of tumor known as a teratoma. Interestingly, the name comes from the Greek word teras, which means monster, and oma means tumor. So teratoma actually means monster tumor. In this video, we're going to learn what these tumors are, how they're caused, and what the typical course of treatment looks like for a patient. Before we begin getting into teratomas, let's cover some relevant biology to make sure we can understand how tumors can occur in general. In our bodies, two types of cells exist, somatic and germline. Somatic cells, sometimes referred to as vegetal cells, are involved in building the body and its different components. Germline cells are the cells that participate in sexual reproduction. To put it simply, germline cells are eggs in females and sperms in males, while somatic cells are what make up the rest of our bodies. Some other examples of somatic cells would be bone cells, muscle cells, nerve, and blood cells. These cells are differentiated, meaning they have undergone changes that give them their assigned role. This is why a bone cell looks and acts completely different than a red blood cell. Germ cells, on the other hand, are known as pluripotent, meaning they can still become any other type of cell in the body. Throughout our lives, our cells are dividing. Somatic cells do this through a process known as mitosis. Through this process, the DNA of the cell is condensed and arranged in a specific manner. DNA is moved to the opposite ends of the cell, and then the cell splits into two identical daughter cells. Mitosis is responsible for development and growth, cell replacement, and asexual reproduction. Germline cells undergo division as well in a similar process called meiosis. The same events occur here as mitosis, except meiosis has a second division step, producing four non-identical daughter cells. This process is mainly needed to make egg and sperm cells for sexual reproduction and ensures that the resulting organism gets the correct number of chromosomes. Our cells have a cellular cycle that they go through. It's not necessary to understand every stage of this, but you should know that mitosis and meiosis are part of it. As well, there are multiple checkpoints throughout the cycle where the cell will assess everything to make sure the steps were done correctly and that there are no mistakes or damages. If something is wrong or is detected during a checkpoint, the cell will commit suicide via programmed cell death, also known as apoptosis. While cell division and proliferation may be important, having these controls in place is crucial as well. Problems with these checkpoints or with the mechanisms of apoptosis will result in cancer through unchecked and rapid division. Cancer can happen through a variety of pathways. Problems with any of the mechanisms mentioned previously can lead to a cancerous tumor growth. What causes teratoma specifically is a little less understood, but there are a few theories. It's possible that they arise from remnants of something called a primitive node, which is a structure present at the beginning stages of embryo development. By week 3 of pregnancy, the fetus's primitive node will normally shorten and disappear. It is theorized that remnants of this node do not disappear could cause teratomas. Another theory is that teratomas arise from primordial germ cells. These are the germline cells that are present in a developing fetus before they differentiate into sperm or egg cells. It is possible that these primordial cells do not migrate to their target destination correctly and may develop into teratomas rather than healthy germ cells. Now, because teratomas are coming from the germline cells rather than somatic ones, they are able to differentiate into many different types of tissues as tumor formation occurs. This is what makes it possible for hair, teeth, and even eyes to grow on them. Because they originate from germline cells, these tumors are most typically found in the testes, ovaries, but can be found in other areas such as the tailbone. Typically, patients with this type of tumor will have it removed surgically and require no further treatment. This is the case in most patients. If the tumor became too invasive or is located in a spot that's difficult to reach surgically, other methods such as chemotherapy may be explored.